Yo, 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 fam, what up? Welcome back again to my classic series, Accounting for Beginners, number 37. I remember that year. That's the year I got my CPA license, a short 3 years ago. Anyways, who am I? I am CPA Strength. I'm the strongest CPA in Florida. I'm a licensed CPA in the state of Florida. One of the 500,000 CPAs in America. It's 500,000. Let's get this in. Anyways, it's 4th of July weekend. What am I doing? I'm grinding. Grinding's fun. Told you I'm gonna be here. Monday, Wednesday, Friday. New accounting videos. I'm here. Here. I'm really excited. I'm really excited about this one. As I was drawing it out, making my presentation on the board, I thought, God, this is really making sense. This is gonna really help. This is gonna help people. Like, I know when I put this video out, this is gonna actually help people understand net income. Let's get started. Accounting for Beginners number 37 is net income. I don't know. Yeah, up here, I think, I don't even know, is gonna be the best playlist in the world, the best accounting playlist in the world. If you wanna go look, there's close to 40 videos now. 37 if you're watching this, but if you're watching it from the future and you wanna come back in time, there's gonna be about 1,000 videos. Anyways, this is my mapping system. If you don't know it, you should learn it. If you're having problems with accounting, where DCA, LRD, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. This is net income. One of the problems that I had when I started with accounting was the difference between gross and net. A couple different ways you could think about it is if you get your paycheck, $10 an hour, 40 hours a week, that's $400. That's your gross amount. I think this is finally how it broke through in my head, how gross and net worked. So I picture, this is me with a smile because I got my little net. I got my net, and that's kind of what I took home. Because I see like gross everything, and then my little net, like it just, like everything goes through my net, like little fishes or something. Like the gross is the fishes, and then my net is like what I'm taking home. My little fishing bag. That's what I'm taking home, the net. For like net income. Net income. I don't know anything, but I do know gross is everything and net's what I'm taking home. Alright. What I'm taking home income. Probably how much money I'm taking home. What net income is revenue minus expenses. It's income, revenue's income. Revenue is like the gross. Or what's net income? It's the net what you take home of your income. So it's actually, net income is the summary of the income statement. The income statement is revenue minus expenses. And this is where your net income is gonna be derived from. Just bare bones. I think this is really gonna help to illustrate how net income plays a part and how net income is the final of the income statement and is also carried over to the balance sheet. Now I could be wrong. I don't think I am though. Net income is the only number, when you're talking balance sheet, income statement, it's the only number that's on both. So I'd say, I don't know why I waited until number 37 to talk about net income when it's possibly one of the most important numbers, because it's on two, in my opinion, the most important statements. So it's on the two most important statements. Sorry. I'm not perfect, and we all know that. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh! Ooh, my squats killed me yesterday. I did 10x10 German volume training, because I am 50% German. Boy, getting jacked, though. You have an accounting business. You do bookkeeping. $2,000 for the whole year. You have one client. You start up new. You find one dude. He says, I'll give you $2,000 to do bookkeeping. You're like, great. So let's do that. We did that during the year. We did the bookkeeping for $2,000. That's our service revenue. Journal entry. is gonna be, because we're getting money, we're gonna debit the cash, credit the bookkeeping revenue. Debit cash, credit revenue. So look, here's the balance sheet. Cash, $2,000. The income statement, $2,000. Because, gotta remember, down here is the income statement. Up here is the balance sheet. Cash, bookkeeping revenue. This is income, bookkeeping revenue, income statement, cash, balance sheet. So that's how we got the 2,000s here. For the service revenue, that's on the income statement, and then $2,000 is now what you have on the balance sheet. Now we're gonna have one more transaction, that's all that happened, because nothing else happened except you found one dude, he said, I'll give you two K jizzles. You're like, great. And then you're like, I got no place to make my 2K jizzles. And then you found somebody that said, I'll rent you a place for $1,000. And that sounded good to you too. So you got your kind of Robin Peter to pay Paul here. And where's Mary? Tell her to come on now. Because you got your $2,000. And now you've been making your chippers, your 2,000 chippers. And the guy's like, yo, I need $1,000 for the rent. You're like, damn, I just had two. I'm thinking about even not answering your phone. It's about running from the plug. Don't run off on the plug. That's a stupid song. Don't ever do that. God, I forgot because it's about the plug. Oh. So you had to pay. I don't like paying money. I don't like outgoing money. That makes me disheveled. So you have your rent of $1,000 going out. What's the journal entry for that going to be? Journal entry for that's going to be, look, we got $1,000 rent expense. That's going to be your debit. Okay? And that's also on the income statement. What's the credit? Well, you're going to have money going out. For an expense, you got money going out. That's sad, sad day. So that is an asset cash, but it's going to be going out, so it's going to be a credit. All right, so that's the journal entry. So on the income statement, it's going to be on expenses, $1,000. For the balance sheet, it's going to be under cash, but it's leaving, so it's going to be negative $1,000. So let's tally up our, now we're at the end of the year. We had two transactions for the year. Those two transactions made this occur on the income statement, made this occur on the balance sheet. Now we're going to do our year end and get our net income to know how much we're going to pay for our taxes and blah, blah, blah. Let's go to the income statement first and get our net income. Income statement is revenue minus expenses. Our revenue was $2,000. Our expenses was $1,000. That leaves our net income of $1,000. $2,000 minus $1,000 is $1,000. So that's our net income. That's what we had. The net income transfers over to our balance sheet. Let's peep this out. Look at this net income. This net income, $1,000. Simultaneously, it transfers over to the balance sheet. It's like magic. It's magic. Transfers over to, look, the balance sheet, $1,000. Now, does that work for the balance sheet? Let's see. Balance sheet is assets equal liability plus equity. We've gone over that. For our assets, we have $1,000 cash because we had $2,000 in our balance sheet assets cash section. We had $2,000, spent $1,000. $2,000 minus $1,000 is $1,000. Now that has to equal $1,000 on our balance sheet from our assets. Cash has to equal liabilities plus equity. There are no liabilities plus equity. What's under our equity? The only thing we have under our equity is net income. And that so it balanced the balance sheet balances. That's the income statement. That's how it's done. And that's net income. You know, definitely I am the underdog, and I want to be here for the people that, you know, Your whole life, all you've been hearing is negative, 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 negative. You know, you've done nothing right in your whole life. Well, that's bullshit, man. I'm here to tell you, you can turn it all around. Maybe you need some individual activities to do, because I used to always play team sports. I was just never one of the premier. No one ever thought I was any good, even though I worked my ass off and I got to be one of the best people on any team I was on. You know, I'd still sit the bench or just because the coach didn't like me. Individual sports, individual stuff's really the way to go for me. And maybe for someone who's been getting shit on your whole life, but you're like, dude, I'm good, I can do this. Like, getting a college degree, you know, that's just on you. It doesn't matter if everyone hates you. You do the work, you get the good grades, you get your degree. My professional license, my CPA license. Well, it took me, you know, I had to schmooze the accounting, the state board over. I had to schmooze my employers over. But to pass the actual test, yes, to pass the actual CPA test is just you versus the test. And, you know, everyone else can think you're stupid. Everyone else can think whatever about you. But you put that work in, you pass. Also, really, with my YouTube channel, that's why I'm so passionate and so loving about it, because I realized that the more time that I put in, no matter what anybody else says, this channel will be successful, this channel will grow. So thank you. I'm gonna be back here again. This is Monday's video. Tomorrow is 4th of July. Stay blessed.